वन्दे वाञ्छितलाभाय कर्म किं तन्न कथ्यते किं दम्पतिमिति ब्रूयाम् उदाहो दम्पति इति सो बृहस्पति डिसाइडेड टू कम एंड ही केम देयर एंड गेव एन एडवाइस टू इंद्र इति आकाशगिरा शक्रः मत्या च क्रूरया स्वया यावत् डोलायते तावत् आगत्य अबोधयत् गुरुः. Just as Indra was in a dilemma to do what, whether to follow what the Akasha Vani was trying to tell him, Ashariri Vak was trying to tell him, or to proceed with the cruel decision of committing suicide, Tanum Tyajami. He was oscillating between the two. Yavatu Dolayate, Tavatu Guruhu Abodayate. At that time, Brihaspati came and gave him an advice. What was the form of the advice that Brihaspati did?
बृहस्पतेः बोधनं हन्त कथम् एतत् अमरपतेः धीमतोऽपि ते दुर्व्यसवसितुम् अविदितं न ते वेदितव्यम् अवशेषितं वा गुरूणाम् उपासनं किं न जानासि भवितव्यतां किं वा अभिमन्यसे जयश्रियो नयत्यम्
नयत्यं हन्त कथम् एतत् अमरपतेः धीमतः अपि ते व्यवसितं ते दुर्व्यवसितं सी अमरपतेः अपि धीमतः अपि देर् आर् टु एड्जेक्टिव्स् दट् ही गिव्स् हियर् वन् इस् यू आर् रेस्पान्सिबल् फार् द लैव्स् आफ् द सिटिज़न्स् हू आर् लिविङ्ग् इन् अमरपुरी and amara amaranam patihi you are the lord of all the devas so you are in a position of responsibility and you cannot do such an action how can you even think of such a durvyavasitam dukhena vyavasitam that is something which should not be done at all and which results in grief so durvyavasitam how can the king of amaras further if you are an unintelligent moodha I'm okay I can accept I can't do anything about it but you are a dhiman brihaspati he learned everything from brihaspati knows as a guru if a guru gives a shishya the certificate then you can take it as valid right dhiman guru says to indra that you are a dhiman you are an intelligent person despite being an intelligent person how can you venture into such an action which is which gives result only to a bad merit so durte itham durvyavasitam katham even though you are intelligent aviditam nate veditavyam there is no aviditam iti kinchidapi te na veditavyam you are not in a position where you don't understand anything or you don't know anything and there is something that has to be understood by you so you know everything That is what it means. It gives a negative and says here, we're saying, te kimapi aviditam asti iti kimapi na veditavyam. So you don't have to understand something because you have not understood something. Why do you go to someone and ask? Because you don't understand, right? And the same way, gurunam upasanam kimapi avasheshitam iti na. There is nothing that na should come from the before phrase okay so aviditam na veditavyam athava avasheshitam gurunam upasanam iti kinchidapi te na asti avasheshitam that which is reminder the guru has explained to you 99% you still have 1% left that is not the case with you so kimapi na avasheshitam tatra kim na janasi bhavitavyatam beyond all this so what is your knowledge is something and what should happen is fate right you are absolutely cognizant of what is fate and what will happen bhavitavyata bhavitavyam this is what should happen bhavitavyata is the nature of fate the nature of something that has to happen so bhavitavyatam kim na janasi don't you know the aspect of the fate kimva abhimanyase jayashriyah nayatyam niyate niyatasya bhavah niyatah it's what to say solid that it will definitely happen its definitiveness I don't know if that word even exists but yes jayashriyah if you look at the victory or the Lakshmi that is associated with victory, it is not that she is going to definitely be with the asuras. Haven't you seen it before? There have been so many incidents where we have seen her fickle-mindedness. So, Kimva, otherwise, do you think highly, Abhimanyase, do you think highly of Jayashree's Niyatattvam? The quality of being solid or permanent, the permanence of Jayashree. Ah, that is better. So, do you think greatly of Lakshmi's permanence? No, right? Because nano shruyate eva. Next, he substantiates it.
Nanu shruyate eva puraneshu bhavata yatkila mali sumali sangare mahati parivartamane parachine patagapatau bhagavatapi paravavrite atakena andhakena kila idam adhitishtata adhishtitam trailokyam vidyandani eva kiyanti vijitani tarakena.
So he gives examples of the asura's victory in the past. Nanu shruyate bhavata puraneshu, you have heard in the puranas all these that happened before. Mali and Sumali sangare, in the battle between Mali and Sumali, they were all Mali and Sumali are actually the brothers of Malyavan, who is Ravana's grandfather. So Mali, Sumali and Malyavan were brothers. So during that battle, when they were fighting against the Devas and Vishnu was also heading the Deva army at that point of time, Mahati Sangare Parivartamane Sati. When a great battle was ensuing at that point of time, Patagapadau Parachine Sati. Parachinaha Parangmukaha. So when Garuda had turned his face, at that point of time, Bhagavata Api Paravavrute, Vishnu also moved away from the battle. But the end of it, why he is pointing this out is because he wants to say, even though Garuda moved, Garuda turned his face and Vishnu also turned away from the battlefield, the end result was the Devas won. Okay, it's only when Ravana came about and he established his supremacy over the Devas and he established Lanka. He took away Lanka from Kubera and only then did Mali, Sumali, Malyavan and all of them came and settled down with him in Lanka. So until then, they did not have any supremacy over Swarga. Even though at one point it seemed as if the Devas would lose. Right? So Ata Kena Kila Idam Trilokyam Adishtitam. So how can you say that someone is ruling this Triloka? All three worlds are being ruled by only this set of people. Who can say with the with proof that only this set of people have ruled this country for long? It belongs to nobody else. You can't say that, right? So you have seen that Sumali and Mali had tried to do, but then the Devas again won over and came back. Here there is another reading where instead of Atha Kena, Andha Kena is also mentioned. It depends on what is there in your material. If the material has Andha Kena, then you can say Andhaka was another asura. He was actually born from Shiva's, I think Parvati, when she tried to close Shiva's eyes, from that darkness, Andhaka was born. And Andhaka was also trying to rule, in the sense he was so arrogant, being Shiva's son, he was so arrogant that he even wanted to be with Parvati. Someone came and advised him, Prahlada came and advised him that Parvati is your mother and you can't think like that about her. So even Andhaka tried to rule the three worlds. So then Vidyandani eva kiyanti vidyandani tarakena vijitani. Tarakasura also had how many worlds? Vidyandani brahmandani kiyanti vijitani tarakena. Taraka had also won over so many brahmandas, but today you ruled. After all those things, you saw that the Devas came back to power. So remember that.
तदलम् अनुस्मर शापान्तवचनम् अत्याश्रमस्य मुनेः भवेयुरपि कदाचित् अन्यथा एव भाषितानि महेश्वरस्य न तु जातु माहेश्वराणां यत् पुरा उदितं गोविन्द एव कुशलानि करिष्यति इति महर्षिणा तत् अनूदितम् अग्रे भवितव्यम् अन्यथा इति अधुना परमेष्ठिना तदेहि किञ्चित् कालम् अन्तर्हिता एव क्वचित् आवसाम् इति अनुशिष्य शिष्यम् अन्तर्धाप्य स्वयोगमायया तिरोदधे स्वयमपि देशिको देवतानाम्.
तद् अलम्. सो डोण्ट् थिङ्क् अबौट् एनी आफ् दीस् थिङ्ग्स्. इनफ्. अनुस्मर शापान्तवचनम्. सो सी हौ पासिटिव् हि इस् सेयिङ्ग्. डोण्ट् कीप् थिङ्किङ्ग् अबौट् वाट् हेस् हेपेण्ड्. यु आल्वेस् नो देट् फेट् देर् इस् नो पर्मनेन्स् टु विक्ट्री. सो एनिबडि हू हेस् बीन् विक्टोरियस् बिफोर् कुड् इमीडियट्लि हेव् अ फाल् टु. इफ् समन् हेस् हेड् अ फाल् यु केन् आल्वेस् बिकम् विक्टोरियस् लेटर्. सो अनुस्मर शापान्तवचनम् अत्याश्रमस्य मुनेः दुर्वाससः शापान्तवचनम्. यु रिमेम्बर् द वर्ड्स् दट् ही टाक्ड् अबौट् द शापस्य अन्त, हौ द शाप इस् गोयिङ्ग् टु फिनिश्. यु थिङ्क् अबौट् दोस् वर्ड्स् कान्स्टेण्ट्लि इन् युर् मैण्ड् अण्ड् डोण्ट् थिङ्क् अबौट् वाट् हेस् हेपेण्ड्. रैट्? सो बी पासिटिव् इन् युर् औट्लुक्. अत्याश्रमस्य मुनेः, फोर् दुर्वास हि गिव्स् दि अड्जेक्टिव् अत्याश्रम, अतिक्रान्तः आश्रमान्. इन् द सेन्स् यु ही हेस् क्रास्ड् ब्रह्मचर्य, गृहस्थाश्रम, वानप्रस्थ एण्ड् बिकम् अ सन्यासि. आर् यु केन् आल्सो से आश्रमान् अतिक्रम्य वर्तते. इन् द सेन्स् ही इस् नाट् बौण्ड् बै एनी आफ् दीस् आश्रम, ईवन् द कान्सेप्ट् आफ् आश्रम. सो ही इस् मोर् आफ् अन् अवधूत. And if you look at the description that Nilakantha Dikshita gives for Durvasa, it seems he only recognizes Durvasa as an avadhuta more than anything. And avadhuta is a person who is not bound by any of these rules, from whom the karma has moved away of its own accord. It's not a person who has left the karmas by consciousness. So there is a difference there. The karma which has moved away from them, in the sense, you keep on performing your karmas, at one point you are in that Paramatma Swarupa or that Moksha Swarupam. You are one with that Paramatma to such an extent that this is not going to affect you. The karmas or the fact that you need to perform your duties will not affect you at all. Because you are beyond papa and punya. That is the state of atyashrama. So atyashramasya munehe shapanta vachanam anusmara. Now bhaveyurapi kadachit maheshwarasya bhashitani anyatha eva. Maheshwarasya bhashitani. Even Shiva's words can turn out otherwise. Anyatha bhavishyanti. It is possible that Shiva's words can become differently. In the sense, it can turn different. The outcome might be different for Shiva's words. Najatu Maheshwarana. If Shiva's disciples have said something, it will happen as it should. Vacham Arthonu Davati. In Uttaramacharita, he says, Laukikanam hi sadhunam vak artham anuvartate. Vacham Arthonu Davati. Correct. Rishinam punar adhyanam vacham Arthonu Davati. Those great rishis, for them, they say the words even before the artha comes and sticks with that. The artham will just follow the words that the rishis have said. See, the normal people will only look ahead and see what is going to happen and then say those words. Say they already know the words and then they just follow, they know the artha, that is the meaning, and then they follow with that. So here, Maheshwaranam, Najatu Maheshwaranam, Maheshwarasya Bhashitani, even Shiva's words, Kadachit, sometimes Anyatha Eva Bhaveyuhu Api, even though it may turn out in a different manner, Najatu Maheshwaranam, Maheshwara's disciples, the words that come out of their mouth will never be wrong. So what the Rishi had said before has only been reiterated by this divine voice that came now. So yatu pura before maharshina uditam, the rishi had said, what did he say? Govinda eva kushalani karishyati. Vishnu is going to come, Govinda is going to come, and he will do good later. That tat anu uditam, paschat uditam, it was reiterated by adhuna parameshthina, by Brahma, in the form of the ashariri vak. What did he say? Agre bhavitavyam anyatha, agre later anyatha bhavitavyam, something different is going to happen. In the sense, if you are experiencing a defeat now, definitely a victory is going to happen at the end, later, at a later point. Tadehi. So what is the course of action now? Let's go. Kanchit kalam, for some time. Antarhita eva, being hidden. Kvachit avasama, avasama, let us live somewhere. Somewhere, kvachit, for some time. Antarhita eva, being hidden, let us live elsewhere. Iti shishyam anushishya, thus Brihaspati, so advising his student. Swa yoga mayaya antardhapya, antardhaya, he himself disappeared. Antardhapayati, he makes someone else disappear. It's nijanta here, causal form. So swa yoga mayaya, with his own yoga maya or his maya shakti, he made Indra disappear. Antardhapya swayamapi tirodadhe, who disappeared? Devatanam desikah. Deshikaha guru. Deshopadesham darshayati iti deshikaha. Desha upadeshaha, in the sense, the one who shows you all the practices and customs, the traditional customs that have to be followed. Desha visheshana, desha upadeshana yaha darshayati saha deshikaha. Nice word. So devatanam deshikaha, swayamapi, he himself also disappeared. Next is a shloka where you know, daitya, the asuras are very happy now, and they laugh out loud. As usual, they have to show their enthusiasm. Huh? You have a doubt, Lakshmi?
No.
Ready?
Oh.
Yeah. The next
shloka. Vidrane varune gate hutavahe vaivasvate moochite sadyo lochana gocharada pagate apagate sankrandana syandane samvarta vyati shikta sapta jaladhi srotaha prabhuta dhvani spharaha kopi babhuva danava bale harshattahasa dhvanihi.
Danava bale kopi harsha attahasa dhvanihi babhuva. Among the asuras, there was a huge attahasa, laughter. Harsha, out of, see, attahasa can be out of anger, happiness, both can happen there. Or veera. Veera attahasaha, krodha attahasaha, harsha attahasaha. Depends on the sentiment that is there and that is giving out that, bringing out that sound. So harsha attahasa dhvanihi, the sound of laughter that came, that was present, that happened in the army of the asuras. Koapi always is used for an anirvachaniya. Very difficult to describe it properly. That's why he uses, every time when he wants to describe it, he uses pralaya kalam for a comparison for it, because he is unable to even imagine the asuras and the devas coming together, or even the laughter that comes out or the noise that comes out at that point of time. So what happened then? Vidrane varune, varune vidrane sati, vidrane dhavite sati, when he ran away. Hutavahe gate sati, when Agni had also left. Vaivasvate murchite, because they, what did they do? Antakamapi kaladandam akritya, they hit him, right? Tadaitva, something came there. Where they have, no, pranam jugur nire. I like that sentence where, you know, that shloka, where he said, antakasya antakaha navidyate. Nobody was there. Yeah, there was no yama, another yama to take the pranam of yama. So pranas, yama's pranam were rounding here inside his throat. It's a beautiful description. So vaivasvate murchite sati, when Vivaswan or वैवस्वतः इज यम विवस्वान्स विवस्व विवस्वतः अपत्यं पुमान वैवस्वतः ही इज द सन ऑफ सूर्य सो वैवस्वते मूर्छिते सति व्हेन यमा हेड वाज रेंडर्ड अनकॉन्शियस सद्यः संक्रंदन संध्यने स्यंदने लोचन गोचरात अपगते संक्रंदन इंद्रः इंद्रस्य स्यंदन रथः इंद्रास रथ चैरियट इमीडिएटली वेंट अवे फ्रॉम द रेंज ऑफ परसेप्शन लोचन गोचरात फ्रॉम द साइट रेंज इट वेंट अवे अपगते सति सद्यः इमीडिएटली at that point of time what happened ko api dhvanihi babuva there was a huge sound because the moment the king is gone or he is not there he is not to be seen anywhere it means victory so the indication of victory is the first uproar of laughter and sound that comes about and he describes it with one adjective संवर्त व्यतिशिक्त सप्त जलधि स्रोत प्रभूत ध्वनि स्फारः इट्स साउंड इट इज बीन इट इज एन इंक्रीजिंग साउंड स्फारः वर्धमानः ध्वनिः ओके सो द ध्वनि इज बीन इंक्रीज्ड बिकॉज एंड इट रिसेंबल्स व्हेन द सेवन ओशंस कम टुगेदर ड्यूरिंग द प्रलय नोबडी हैज सीन प्रलयम हियर We don't know how it would be when seven oceans come together. We have only probably seen two streams of water coming together and there is a small noise. So you have to imagine if there are seven different oceans flowing from different directions, coming together and dashing when the waters come together. Imagine the sound that comes about. So samvarta pralaya kale vyatishiktaha militaha sapta jaladayaha. तेषां स्रोतः इव स्रोतः तेषां स्रोतसां प्रभूत ध्वनिरिव ध्वनिः दट इज वेर द उपमा गोस् इट इज लाइक द साउंड इज लाइक दैट ऑफ द सेवन ओशन्स मीटिंग ड्यूरिंग द प्रलय काल ओके तादृशः अट्टहास ध्वनिः दानव बले बभूव विद्राणे वरुणे गते हुतवहे वैवस्वते मूर्छिते सद्यो लोचन गोचराद अपगते संक्रंदन स्यंदने संवर्त व्यतिशिक्त सप्त जलधि स्रोत प्रभूत ध्वनि स्पारह कोपि बभूव दानव बले हर्षाट्टहास ध्वनि the even though he uses harsh words you still can see the padalalityam the beauty of the arrangement of the letters are in such a way that it is easy to recite that is the flow of that meter and the words that he uses that's a style riti next is how the now the king is gone they have to enter the city before they enter they just try to destroy the rest of the people there okay
चकित पालयित स्खलित मूर्छित निष्पतित क्षत विबुधानुधावन निषेधि महारथिकं विजहि जहीहि पाहि निगृहाण गृहाण हर इति उपचित उपचित नाद मेदुरम अवर्तत दैत्यबलम
दैत्यबलम अवर्तत सो दैत्यबलम द एंटायर आर्मी ऑफ असुरास हाउ आर दे उपचित नाद मेदुरम अवर्तत दे वर इंक्रीजिंग द साउंड दैट वाज अराउंड सो उपचित नाद मेदुरम मेदुरम मीन्स व्याप्तम they were as if they were pervading the entire sky with their noise which was increasing upachita nada meduram vyaptam avartata they were as if they were pervading the entire space with their noise that was constantly increasing so what were how were they increasing the noise that was there first they were chasing the people daityabalam actually the let's look at the adjective for the daityabalam first so which is just one the first two padas. So chakita, palayita, skhalita, murchita, nishpatita, kshata, vibhuda. Vibhudaha, all the devas were all chakitaha, afraid. Palayitaha, they were running. When you have attained victory, you should not go chasing behind the people who have already been defeated. This is bully, the action of a bully, right? So that is, it's being described here how they fought or how they attacked people who were all running. They were not attacking people who were holding their ayudha. We had already seen how they had left all their ayudhas. They were not holding their weapons. So this is the difference between a good warrior and a bad warrior, right? So Chakita, they were afraid. Palayita, they were running. Skhalita, faltering in their steps, slipping. Murchita, fainting. Nishpatita, falling. Kshata, they were already dead. Almost, or Kshata means wounded. You can say they are wounded. So such vibhudaha, they were all running. Anudhavana, they followed them. Chasing. They were chasing the devas who were afraid, running or faltering or fainting or falling down, or they were wounded. Now, because of the following Anudhavane, what happened? They chased and stopped their path. Nishedhum Shilamasya iti Nishedhi Maharatikaha. Those great Maharatha, Maharatika is a person who has some, how many under his command? I think it is a position in the army. Each Rathi, Maharathi and all are different positions where under, in your command, you will have a certain number of soldiers. So in the Daitya army, you find the Maharathikas who are all Nishedhinaha. They were stopping the Amara, the Devas who are all running. So these people were chasing them and stopping them. Tadrisham Daityabalam. So it is an adjective to that. Yasmin Daityabale Maharathikaha Nishedhinaha Bhavanti. Tadrisham Daityabalam. Now how did they increase the sound? So when you chase and when you try to hit the enemies, even the sound that is increased at that point of time is they don't just chase normally. They say Vijahi. Kill them. Jahihi, no, leave them. Don't try to pull them. You know, you can let go of this person. Jahihi, Pahi, no, this person is Asmadiyaha. He is part of us. He is a Rakshasa. You can call him as a Daitya Deva. So Pahi, protect him. Nigrahana, imprison him. No, Grihana, pull him or catch hold of him. Hara, pull him away. Take him away. These are all the words that they are talking amongst themselves, and those shouts increase the sound that is there when they are attacking. I found out that about Jahihi when I was just randomly looking at that word. There are some five different forms for this Jahihi. Just Lot Lakara Madhyama Purusha. That's all. It is so simple. And Jahati is the Lat Lakara if you find. More interesting was the Bhattikavyam Shlokam that he the Vyakhyata Tippanikara had mentioned the shloka, so I looked it up and it was a very nice shloka. Jahihi shokam vaidehi, pritaye dehi manasam, ravane jahihi dvesham, jahahi pramadavane. Bhattikavyam is supposed to be written only to highlight the grammar points. So he has taken three different forms of that Lot Lakara Madhyama Purusha and included it in this one shloka itself. Found it very, very beautiful. Vaidehi, shokam jahihi, let go of your. So this is where Hanuman comes and tells Sita to, conveys Rama's message and says, you come, Rama is waiting for you at the end. After the war has happened, Hanuman comes and says, you come, Rama is waiting to accept you. At that point of time, he comes and says, Vaidehi, shokam jahihi, let go of your shoka, grief. Preetaye manasam dehi. We saw this dehi also in that shloka. What is that? Antardehi. Antaha dehi. I think it is that Akash. Antardehi ranadasmat antaha dehi cha madgiram. Place your mind, you know, have the, my words in your mind in a very proper manner. So the same way he says pritaye manasam dehi, keep your associate your mind with preeti or nice words. Ravane jahihi dvesham, let go of your hatred towards Ravana. Jahahi pramadavanam, leave this udyanam Ashokavanam and come. Nice one. Jahihi shokam vaidehi. Okay. Chakita palayita skhalita murchita nishpatita krata vibuda anudhavana nishedhi maharathikam vijahi jahihi pahi nigrihana grihana harieti upachita nada meduram avartata daityavana. Now, at the same time, how are they behaving? Not only they were chasing after those who were running, you know, the victor always gets the loot. So the moment you enter the city, you have to start looting and taking everything. That is being described here. They're looting.
Apicha avrityavartayanto dishi dishi turagan varanan varayanto mushnanto bhushanani prasabha prasamam abhinipatya ayudhanya harantaha ghnanantaha santarjayantaha pathi pathi vibudhan muktakeshan digishan abhetya mantrayantaha prajaha surasuraha sarvato nirvishankam
prajahasuhu asuraha sarvataha nirvishankam asuraha prajahasuhu, they laughed very greatly. Prahasati, they kept laughing. Sarvataha nirvishankam, everywhere nirvishankam, without any fear they were laughing at what was happening. You don't laugh at the havoc that you create, but that is the victor's attitude. So dishi dishi turagan avritya avartayantaha, they were rounding in all directions, dishi dishi in all directions, turagan avritya, they surrounded the horses that were there, and avartayantaha, they were pushing them towards, see, in a herd of cows, if you try to go and surround it on the opposite directions, the ones which are going in front will turn and keep moving towards yourself, right? Towards the other side, whichever direction you want. So the idea is to surround it and then you make it move in the direction that you want to. That is what they were trying to do to the horses here. Dishi dishi in every direction, turagana avritya, they surrounded the horses, and avartayantaha, they were turning them towards their armies. Sva sainyana prati avartayantaha, that is understood here. Varanana varayantaha, they were stopping the elephants. Varanaha gajaha, so gajana varayantaha. Bhushanani mushnantaha, they were stealing ornaments from everybody. Abhinipatya, they ran towards prasabam abhinipatya. Prasabam abhinipatya ayudhani aharantaha. If some of, most of them had dropped their weapons, if some of them had were carrying their weapons, they ran towards them. Abhinipatya prasabam, forcefully. Ayudhani aharantaha, they were taking away the ornaments from them with force. Grantaha, they were killing, and santarjayantaha, they were threatening pathi pathi at every step. They were killing and threatening muktakeshana vibudana. The devas had all opened their locks out, keshaha, their hair. They opened all their hair and they were running everywhere. See, you don't give attention to your hair at that point of time. Or vibudaha, you can also say it is vibudas three who had let go of their hair decorations, and they were all running everywhere. So pathi pathi, at every step or at every margam, vibudana muktakeshana vibudana ghanantaha, they were killing devas who had spread, opened out their locks, hair, and they were threatening them also. Digishana sarvataha abhyetya amantrayataha amantrayantaha. So digishana, they sarvataha, dikpalaka are in those specific directions. So what did these asuras do? Sarvataha, from all directions they went and rounded, or they approached these dikpatis and Amantrayantaha, they were calling those Dikpatis to come for fight. What did they do? The Swadishaha Eva Gataha. We saw it in Shloka. Sambrantaha Pratipedire Yudhi Nivrittasha Digisha Dishaha. Dishaha, the Digishaha, Dishaha Pratipedire. They went to their respective corners and stayed, these Dikpatis. So they were calling them from their corners. So Amantrayantaha, these asuras were calling those Digishaha, Digishan Abhyetya Sarvataha. Amantrayantaha ityukte sangramartham, yuddhaya amantrayantaha asuraha prajahasuhu ahasam. They laughed looking at the plight of all these devas. Okay. There's no particular alankara in this. There's nothing that I saw. Avritya avartayanto dishi dishi turagana varanan varayantaha mushnanto bhushanani prasabham abhinipatya ayudhani aharantaha ghnantaha santarjayantav patipati vibudan muktakeshan digishan abhyetyamantrayantav prajahasur asuraha sarvato nirvishankam. Next. Next is how this is how the Amarapuram was at that point of time when these people were all entering, right? Shastra Shastri.
Kincha Shastra Shastri Kshatapati Sutaloka Shokava Lukta Pranastraina Vraja Masha Rana
Vrajam Asharana
Vrajam Asharana dvasta luptapanantam dhavaddeva pravara samarodanta
yathartya bodha
bhramyat pauram nagaram bhava nagaram abhavat jarjaram nirjaranam
nirjaraha nirjaraha jara yesham nasti nirjaraha devaha nirjaranam nagaram jarjaram abhavat. So nirjaranam nagaram jarjaram abhavat is actually so nirjaranam nagaram is in prathama vibhakti, the rest are all in dvitiya vibhakti as a kriya visheshanam to abhavat. Okay. So that the city became in a very dilapidated condition. Jarjaraha, it was it was just completely shaken. Jarjaraha abhavat, jarjaram abhavat nagaram. So how else did it become? All those four adjectives. So the first one we saw is this jarjaram. This the first one that is written is shastra ashastri krata Pati Suta Aloka Shoka Avalupta Prana Straina Vraja. It became crowded, or all these ladies who were all there in that city, Straina Vraja, Straina Samuha, Stri Samuha, Desham Pranaha Avaluptaha, Shokena Avaluptaha. Their minds were all completely immersed in grief. All the ladies in the city were all completely upset because of what? By seeing Aloka, by seeing their husband and children wounded or dead. Either way, Kshata can be either dead or wounded. So Kshata, Pati Suta, Alokat, Kshoka. So because of that, they were very angry, upset from that, and their Shokena Avalukta Pranaha. Now, how were they wounded? From the yuddham. The yuddham here is described as shastra shastri. It's a very peculiar samasa where you say shastraihi shastraihi prakritya yuddham pravrittam. You have kesha keshi or mushta mushti, mushtaihi mushtaihi cha, keshaihi keshaihi cha prakritya idam uddham yuddham pravrittam. It is a very specific samasa used for yuddham or any kalaham that started. With the hands, if they were fighting, it is called mushta mushti, hasta hasti, or kesha keshi, they were holding their hands and their hair and they were fighting, pulling hairs and fighting, it is Keshageshi. It's a specific type of how that yuddham happened. Here it is only by weapons, luckily. No wrestling or hair pulling and all that was there. So shastra shastri yuddhe kshataha patayaha sutaha cha. So those who were dead in the battlefield that happened between weapons. Tatra kshatapati suta aloka shokena avalukta pranaha striyaha. Okay. Tadrisham nagaram. And then the next adjective is asharana dvasta lupta apanantam. Now first the ladies are all very upset about it. Next, what were the descriptions? If you looked at Amarapuri description, the first he described the people there, and then the apanam, vithi, how prosperous the roads were all, the shopping streets and all were. So apanantam, the until the inner roads, everything were just looted. People had just stolen everything or destroyed everything because the nobody was protecting those streets of Amarapuri. So and the nagaram, the city, was not at all protected. Asharana. Tasmat karanat dvastaha luptaha cha. Dvastaha, it was destroyed. And luptaha, it was completely, nothing was there. Completely destroyed. So dvasta is attacked or destroyed. Lupta means even the objects were stolen away. That is lupta. From apana antam, you know the how many streets he had described before. So here it is not only in the periphery that they had attacked and looted the shops. They had gone until the interior of the shops and they had looted them. So apanantam gatam tadrisham abhavat. The nagarasya apanantam dvastam luptam cha abhavat. Kasmat karanat asharana karanat. So because there was nobody to protect it. Next, Dhavat Deva Pravara Samara Udanta Yathartya Bodha Brahmyat Poram. The citizens were all roaming around to understand what was the truth, what had happened. Did the Devas really run away from the battlefield? Did Indra, disappear from the battlefield? What happened? What happened? You know, people are, when there is no news, you make news. So people were making up rumors. And because of those rumors, people wanted to know what the truth was. To know the truth, they kept asking each and everybody, roaming around the city entirely. So, tadrisham nagaram abhavat. Nagaram brahmyat pauram abhavat. It became a city where people were all roaming around, brahmyat pauram. For what? Yatharthya. Yatharthasya bhavaha yatharthyam. Satyasya bhavaha. So in order to know, tasya jnanaya bodhaya brahmyate yadartya bodhaya jnanam. So what is the truth that they wanted to know? Samara udanta, about the story of the war. What is, among whom, what is the story that they wanted to know? Dhavata deva pravara. The war in which the great devas were all running away from. Samara udanta yadartya bodha brahmyat pauram nagaram abhavat. Why I have specifically mentioned that these four are kriya visheshana is, he says there is no chamatkaram if you just say that if all of these are just a visheshana to the nagaram. Tadrisham nagaram jarjaram abhavat. It became dilapidated or it became jarjara. It doesn't have so much of chamatkara. Whereas if you say nirjaranam nagaram evam abhavat ityukte, then there is a more stress on the different destructions that happened to the city. It's not just that because of all these things the city became very bad. That doesn't hold so much of ramaniyakam or beauty in an expression. If you say that the Deva's city became, you know, where all the the ladies were all very upset, the shopping streets were all looted, and people were all roaming around to know the truth. See, describes the state in its present state, and not as something which happened, and because of that, it has become in a very bad state. I don't know if you get the difference between the two. Just think about it. Putting it as a kriya visheshanam is always much more, it adds more beauty to the expression. शस्त्राशस्त्रि क्षत पति सुतालोक शोकावलुप्त प्राणस्त्रैण व्रजम् अशरण ध्वस्त लुप्त आपणांतम् धावद्देव प्रवर समरोदंत याथार्थ्य बोध भ्राम्यत् पौरम् नगरम् अभवत् जर्जम् निर्जराणाम् जर्जरम् निर्जराणाम्. The next is Sudharma is the Deva Sabha, where the Indra Sabha is called Sudharma, and they had to go and occupy that Darbar. That is where their ultimate victory is seen. He will stop with this, actually. This Ashvasa will stop with how they had occupied the Sudharma. Tataha. Now here, occupation of that is actually, this is a very, very big gadhyam. I don't know if we can do it completely. I will see how the time goes, and maybe we will stop with at a relevant point, at some description, we will stop. Okay?
ततः मुहूर्तो मुहूर्तो देव मूर्ताः इव कोप अनल विस्फुलिंग लिंगाः मुनेः बलिमुखाः मुखद्विषः मुखद्विषः पराक्रमे मखद्विषः पराक्रमेण महता परिक्रामन्तः तिरोहिते मरुत्वति द्राग्ने द्रागेव रणमूर्धनि पलायित इति प्रमीत इति प्रविष्टः अमरावतीम् इति च तादात्विकैः प्रवादभेदैः तत्त्वम् अनुवबुध्यमाना अपि.
सो हियर् इट् इस् आल् आफ् दीस् आर् एन् अड्जेक्टिव् फार् असुर. Let me see where he says that. In the Karasila Varu. Apakranta Haryakshame. It doesn't say Asuraha anywhere, but we just have to understand it from the description that he is being given here. Yeah, he doesn't say that anywhere that it is Asuras. But what they were doing is what is being described here. So tataha muhurta deva, within a moment, within moments of entering the city, what did they do? Murtaha eva kopa anala vispulingaha munehe. Munehe durvasas kopa anala, the kopagni let out a lot of sparks. Vispulinga is sparks. So the sparks that came out of that fire, what is that fire? It was as if they were the personification of sparks coming from the Durvasa's Shapa Anala, Shapa fire. Okay, Murtaha Iva, it is an Utpreksha here. Murtaha means personification of it. They looked as if Durvasa's Kopa Anala and sparks which came out of that Agni had taken a person, or they had taken a form of a person, and these Asuras are them. Bali Pramukha, that is the Asuras here. I forgot, they didn't say Asura. He says Bali Mukhaha, Bali Pramukhaha, Bali, etc. Bali and other Asuras, Makha Dvishaha, who are all enemies of Makha Yagaha. They were all enemies of the Homam. Mahata Parakramena Parikramantaha, with a great valor and show of valor, they were roaming around. Tirohite Marutvati Drageva Ranamurdhani. Drageva immediately, Ranamurdhani in the battlefield, when Marutvan is Indra. Marutu Asya Asti Iti Marutvan. One who protects Vayu is called Indra. Is called Marutvan, and that is Indra. So Marutvati Tirohite Sati, when Ranamurdhani, in the battlefield, when Indra had immediately disappeared quickly, Drageva, at that point of time, what happened? Anavabudhyamanaha, they did not know what the truth was. But people were all talking about different rumors. Tadatvikaihi Pravada Payadaihi, Pravada rumors. The different types of rumors that were happening at that point of time. Tadatvikam Tadanintana Pravadaihi. Pravadaihi tattvam anavabudhyamanaha. They did not know the truth. Tasya bhavaha tattvam. So it's true sense. Whatever is the truth behind these different rumors, they did not know. What were the rumors? Palayitaha iti, he ran away. प्रमीतः इति ही डाइड और अमरावतीं प्रविष्टः ही probably has entered from the battlefield, he has probably entered Amaravati and he is hiding somewhere. These are all the different types of rumors, but the asuras bali mukaha tadatvikaihi pravadabedaihi tattvam anavabudhyamana, they were ignorant because they did not understand the truth because of these rumors. Next.
भवतु नाम सर्वत्थैव वयं प्रविशेम तावत् अमरावतीं परिशोधयेम ततः प्रवृत्तिं शचीपतेः अपहरेम सुरकामिनीः अवस्कन्देम कोशमन्दिरम् अधितिष्ठेम सुधर्मां आक्रमेम त्रैलोक्यम् इति
भवतु नाम लेट इट बी वॉट एवर वेदर ही रैन अवे और ही डाइड और ही इज जस्ट हाइडिंग समवेयर इनसाइड अमरावती वी डोंट केयर दी असुरास सो सर्वदैव वयम अमरावतीं तावत् प्रविशेम लेट अस एंटर अमरावती वी डोंट नीड टू वरी अबाउट व्हाट इज द स्टेटस ऑफ इंद्र. After that, we can probably analyze this situation. So, Tataha, after entering Amaravati, so our goal is to only attain victory and capture the city, right? So, let us first do that. Amaravatim Pravishema Tavat. Tataha, after that, Shachipatehe Pravrittim Parishodhayema. Then we can sit and, you know, analyze what is the situation, what happened to him, and the process, you know, the what happened to Indra, we can then analyze his story. Pravritti. Aparema surakaminihi. Let's take the ladies, take away the Deva ladies by force. And then attack the Kosha Mandira. We have to take possession of the treasury, right? So, avaskandema, let us take possession of the Kosha Mandiram, the treasury. Sudharmam adhitishtema, that is the whole process of this gatyam. Sudharma, sudharmayam tishtamaha, let us go and stand in that darbar, or let us sit in that darbar. So, here sudharmam adhitishtema, adhishingspasam, so you have the saptami has become dvitiya here. Sudharmam adhitishtema, let us go and stay in that Sudharma or the Deva Sabha where they have, you know, ruled the three worlds. We have to go and stand there. That is the show or the sign of victory. And because of standing in that Deva Sena, Deva Sabha, what is the result of that? Akramema Trailokya. Let us win over or possess the entire three worlds. Yeah. Thus deciding, let us overcome or overpower the three worlds. Iti krita nischayaha balimukhaha. Then, now as soon as, after they decided all this, their entire army, they were talking about who will get what. Now that victory has happened, so they know that they are going to go and sit in the Deva Sabha. Now who will take what? There are so many, you know, good things that are there in the Amarapuri. Now you may ask, right, just like how you asked before, when the Kalpadruma is already there, how did it come out of after the Samudra Mathanam? So with the wealth, when Indra went and disappeared, at that point of time, all of their wealth also went and submerged into the ocean, and then they had to bring it out later. Okay? Now, Kalpadruma.
कल्पद्रुमा बलेः कामधेनुः बाणस्य हास्तिकं नमुचेः अश्वीयं शंबरस्य चिन्तामणिः जम्भस्य विलासिन्यः विरोचनस्य वारुणं पदम् अस्य वायवीयं तस्य वैश्वनीयं अमुष्य वैश्वानरीयं एतस्य अपहृत्य लब्धम् अपहर्तुः प्रहत्य लब्धुं प्रहर्तुः आलोकितुः आलोकितम् उपायवक्तुः अधर्म उपायवक्तुः अर्थम् उत्तरसाधकस्य तदर्थं समसमयप्रवृत्तयोः तु साधारणं वस्तु परतस्तु यथारुचि परस्परछन्देन इति समयबन्धेन पर्यवस्थाप्य पताकिनीम्
Patakinim, the army, Paryavasthapya, they split it among themselves or they appointed all these people for these things. They split the responsibility among the army, Paryavasthapya. Patakinim, Paryavasthapya, they arrange their army in such a way, Samayabandhena, according to the position of each one. How you should go and take what you want. So the lowest rung person cannot go immediately and take what he wants. So they have to go by order. Whoever is higher in position will get the first choice. Then the lower in position will get his choice. Okay. So by order, he should do. So first they started with Bali. So Kalpadrumaha Balehe. Kalpadruma, Kalpaka Vriksham will go to Bali. Kamadenu for Bana. Hastikam, Hastinaha Samuham Hastikam, Gaja Samuham. So Gaja Samuham will go to Namuchi, Ashwiyam Shambarasya, horses to Shambara, Chintamani to Jambha, Vilasani was all the ladies. The Apsara Stree will go to Virochana, Varunam Padam, Asya Vayaviyam, Asya, the responsibility or the position of Varuna will go to this person, Vayu, position of Vayu will go to this person. And then Vaishravaniyam, Kubera. Kubera's position to Amushya, Vaishwanariyam, Etasya. You have all the Sarvanama Shabdas here. Asya, Tasya, Amushya, Etasya. Huh? Did he miss out anything? Nothing. So next, Apakritya Labdham Apahartuhu. One who, you know, grabbed the takers. It belongs to the takers, right? Takers are keepers or finders keepers. That's the policy here for this whole small gadya. Apahritya labdham apahartu. One who grabbed something, the one who stole, he will get the stolen items. Apahartuhu, for the person who steals, apahritya labdham, that which was got by stealing. So one who prahritya labdham, one who hits and gets, he will get it. Prahartuhu. One who hits will get that which has been gotten by hitting. Prakritiyana hitting the ne. Okay. The one who took away will get what? The person who executed that will get what he did. Alokituhu alokitam. If you see something, you get it. The one who sees it first will get it. It's like, you know, these kids fight when they see something shiny object in the road. The one who runs and says, I saw it first, so I will take it. You know, that's the attitude which they're saying here. Like children, they were all fighting, it seems. Upaya vaktuhu ardham. One who said the idea will get half. Uttara sadakasya. One who executed it later will get the other half. Tad ardham. Samasamaya pravrtayoho. If both of them went at the same time, it is common to both of them. It is not like they will split it into half, right? So sadharanam vastu. It will be common to both of them. Parataha, afterwards or for the rest of the people, yatha ruchi, as long as however they feel like, they will take it, right? So at other places, parataha, yatha ruchi, as per they wish, paraspara chandena, chandaha, and samaya paraspara chandena, according to each one's wishes. Now, paraspara chandamna, it's actually of their own accord. Of their own accord, yatha ruchi, paraspara chandam is, if I let you go, he can go. If he lets me go, I can go. Nobody is controlling each other, but you are letting each other do what they want. That is paraspara chanda. Swachanda is you are in charge of your own actions. Paraspara chanda is each one will, you know, let go and do things. Iti samaya bandhena. Samaya bandha means shapatam. if you take this, I will take this, or if you let me take this, I will let you take this. That is the sort of an agreement, with a mutual agreement. Samaya Bandena Patakinim Paryavasthapya, they placed the army all around and appointed people, okay, to split the wealth of the Devas. I think we will stop with this. And then how they approached and went inside to occupy the Sudharma as such, the Daitya Sabha, we will see next class. Okay.